I am so excited that you are here. And all the nonies and papas and all the papas and all the pepals and all the grandmothers and all the mimis. And I love having you guys here because I'm one of those too. And I get to have my little granddaughter here. And I am so glad you came to support all of us. And she's going to help me do something here at the beginning. So anyway, we'll see how this goes. I'm not sure about it yet. But thank you for your support and your prayers and for being here. And we'll have our opening prayer in a little bit. But we're going to start out with this. Okay, you ready? Okay. Okay. Grandmas and grandpas are everything nice.
Like presents and candy and raspberry ice.
And chocolate fudge sundaes with cherries on top.
What is it again?
Popcorn and peanuts.
Popcorn and peanuts and grape soda pop.
In winter, in summer, in rain, or in sun.
Grandmas and grandpas are wonderful fun.
Thank you, Annalise. You can go sit back down. I'm Noni, and Popeye's here too. So anyway, we're excited to be here and be grandparents with you. Once again, thank you for your support and your prayers. And we're going to start out with the Junior K and Senior K little group doing some pledges. And then Aiden Vinson is going to be our person who opens us in prayer. And then after that, you're just going to love hearing these wonderful, precious kids. Watch me trip down the steps.
Please stand for the pledges. Attention, salute, pledge. Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word, only commandment to my feet, only human to my path, now hide his word in my heart, though not sins against God.
You may be seated. Please bow your heads to pray. Dear God, thank you for this school so we can learn. God, thank you for my brother and my parents and for all the grandparents. Help us to do good in our program. Amen.
Good morning. And yes, they are like that in class all the time. But we get things accomplished, as you can see. It took us a while to get that W-O-R-L-D, even with the youngest ones, but we made it. They got it. So, and they're learning that God loves them and that God cares for them and that He did create this great, big, beautiful world that we live in. And as we sing these songs today, I hope that you not only enjoy watching your children perform, but also enjoy the concept behind it. Because our theme for this year is the days of creation. Before we go into the first through sixth grade, we're going to enjoy a couple of songs from the band. In the program, you see that they're playing Hot Cross Buns, but they are also playing one called All Together. So the sixth grade band.
Day 1, Genesis 1, 1 through 2. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters.
All you see, all you don't see, earth was a sea of nothingness, a bottomless emptiness, an inky blackness. God's Spirit brooded like a bird over the watery abyss.
And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. Genesis 1.
God saw that the light was good and separated the light from the dark. God named the light day. He named the dark night. It was evening. It was morning. Day 1.
Day 2, Genesis 1, 6 through 8. And God said, "Let there be an expanse between the waters to separate water from water."
So God made sky. He separated the water under the sky from the water above the sky. And there it was. He named the sky the heavens. It was evening. It was morning. Day 2.
Thank you. Genesis chapter 1, 9 to 13. And God said, let the water under the sky be gathered to one place, and let dry ground appear.
And there it was. God named the land earth. He named the pooled water ocean. God saw that it was good.
Then God said, let the land produce vegetation, seed-bearing plants, and trees on the land that bear fruit with seed in it, according to their various kinds.
And there it was. Earth produced green seed-bearing plants, all varieties, and fruit-bearing trees of all sorts. God saw that it was good. It was evening, it was morning, day three.
And God said, let there be light in the expanse of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them serve as signs to mark seasons and days and years. And let them be light in the expanse of the sky to give light on the earth.
And there it was. God made two big lights, the larger to take charge of day and the smaller to be in charge of night. And he made the stars.
God placed them in the heavenly sky to light the earth, to separate light from dark. God saw that it was good. It was evening, it was morning, day four.
Just how much God cares for me. Day 5, Genesis 1, 20 through 23. And God said, let the water teem with living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the expanse of the sky.
God created the huge whales, all of the swarming of life in the water, and every kind and species of flying bird.
God saw that it was good. He blessed them. Prosper, reproduce, fill oceans. Birds reproduce the earth. It was evening. It was morning. Day 5.
Day 6. Genesis 1, 24 through 31. And God said, let the land produce living creatures according to their kind. Livestock, creatures that move along the ground, and wild animal, each according to their kind.
And there it was, wild animals of all kinds, cattle of all kinds, every sort of reptile and bug. God saw that it was good.
Then God said, let us make man in our image, in our likeness. Let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth, and over all the creatures that move along the ground.
God created human beings. He created them godlike, reflecting God's nature. He made them male and female. God bless them.
Prosper, reproduce, fill earth, take charge. Be responsible for the fish in the sea and the birds in the air, for every living thing that moves on the face of the earth.
Then God said, I'll give you every sort of seed-bearing plant on earth and every kind of plant food tree on earth, giving them to you for food.
To all animals and all birds, everything that moves and breathes, I give whatever grows out of the ground for food. And there it was.
God looked over everything he had made. It was so good, so very good. It was evening, it was morning, day 6.
Thank you.
the seventh day, God had finished all the work he had been doing. So on the seventh day, he rested from all his work.
Heaven and earth were finished down to the last detail. God blessed the seventh day. He made it a holy day because on that day he rested from his work. All the creating God had done. This is the story of how it started in heaven and earth when they were created.